glad we got into it, and I know we're going slightly off topic, but it's a good topic, and specifically because certainly the three of us are public figures. Now, I have a big CNBC logo that sits above me every time I talk, and I have a production team which tells me immediately if I'm shilling, because they immediately cut it out. But the two of you have huge public audiences, and you're both very influential in your own rights. And again, you can be the difference between a success and a failure of an ICO. We've seen it many, many times. ICOs that you fall behind, or that you back, be it with your own money or with your credibility, will perform better than ICOs that don't. Do you genuinely carry a sense of responsibility on your shoulders, beyond the responsibility to make your own money? Do you genuinely walk around and think, if I sell this, I could be hurting the investor community?
Yes, absolutely. The bigger I get, the more homework I have to do on a project. So, for example, we've been doing more homework on a project here for the last 6 months. And we've been doing homework on them for 6 months because we know if we end up going in and backing them, just by us being associated with that project, is going to be the whole Ian Balina effect. And we have to make sure that if we go into a project, we're very certain it's a good project, all-star team, great product, great everything. Almost has to be bulletproof, so to speak, because I know some people, unfortunately, tend to just invest blindly based on what I say sometimes, and as much as I try to control that, I can't always stop that, right? So we have to make sure if we back something, it's something we believe is very solid.
I'm going to hand it over to you, Michael, because you've got a big community yourself. Do you feel a sense of responsibility, specifically being such a big influence in this space?
I do, yes. It's funny because, you know, if I was reviewing anything else, I'd probably feel quite safe. Okay, so if I was a film reviewer and I gave the film 3 out of 5 stars, that's it, I can leave it there. You know, I give my personal opinion and that's it. People respect it or they don't respect it, they go watch it or they don't watch it. But with a cryptocurrency, it changes over time. When you first get into it, sometimes it can be amazingly brilliant, and then it can get worse over time. And then you may think, you know what, my time has run out as an investor with this project. I'm gonna sell it. But when you do that, you know, you can't. The community come to you for social. They always come to you for proof. It's like they come to you to see if something is good. They come to you to see if something is bad, or to sensor check whether something's good or bad. And as soon as you sell, you know, and even though I'm selling for my own personal reasons, other people lose interest or confidence. Well, there's that potential. It doesn't always happen. But people can lose that interest and sell. And I don't want that responsibility necessarily. I like to say how I feel about an ICO, and I'd love to say what I do with it, but I am, of course, hesitant of what I share about selling things that I have talked about before, because the backlash.